warm welcome to you on this most pleasantly clear evening. As you can see, we are getting through the pre-match formalities and processes, the players coming onto the field for the usual fanfare and handshakes and so on. Conditions absolutely perfect. Temperatures are kind enough. It is an absolute picture under the floodlights here, and the match that follows ought to follow suit. This famous stadium, for so long one of the symbols of Italian dominance in Europe. The lineup we have suggests it's going to be a 4-5-1 formation, Jim.
Well, this setup, Peter, can be very defensive if that midfield is in place purely to form a protective layer in front of the back four. But it can also be the launchpad to very quick counter-attacks. If you can offer pace and accuracy on the front foot, it can have a devastating effect, actually, at the offensive end of the pitch, too.
There's the whistle.
Neustädter.
Calderil.
Neustädter.
Could move up a gear here. Ball's loose. Who's getting there?
And it's Sosa.
Big chance here. Forward. What does he try from here?
Now it's Slimani. Slimani spreads it towards the left.
The understanding between those two plays a big part in that, and releasing the run onside proved the key ingredient.
Fenerbahce
ahead, one goal to the good.
Hardly anything between the sides, and it's 1-0.
Going through, and now they can launch a counter. Chance! It's on! It's in! And already they're looking to run away with it. Time and space aplenty, he was never going to miss.
But the goal was well manufactured, but the striker probably can't believe he's been given that much space in the penalty area. And he wasn't going to miss.
Fenerbahce
took a two-goal lead, and things should be comfortable from here on in.
Well, unsurprisingly, Peter, the opposition look completely stunned. I'm not sure they can gather themselves.
Tries to dink it in. Looks to clip it forward. It's the goalkeeper's to play.
Benazzi plays a clever pass.
Ayew.
Slimani.
He's made sure that that won't get through.
Plays it out to the flank. Onazi
with a good steal, well played. All the way back and they start again. Played out to the right.
João Pereira
looking to get on the end of this. He gets! It's in! Half-time rapidly approaching. That could be a big one. That's no fluke. It's what he was there for.
Oh, look, there's only one player who merits all the praise for that. Not only did he finish it, but his instincts for being where he was, absolutely top-notch.
This
is threatening to become a really good game.
Well, it was important they didn't get ahead of themselves.
That'll be the last act of the first half.
So a really good half of football, three goals and just one separating them.
Well, it remains very delicately poised, and based on the promise we've seen through the first 45 minutes, I wouldn't be surprised if this takes another twist or two. It certainly would be in keeping.
Fenerbahce head
into the half-time break with a narrow lead, 2-1. Already up and running for the second half. It's caught in there, it's a free kick. To win it back. Sosa. Play for a throw. And it's Sosa. Played into space out wide. Ayu tries to get it forward quickly. Yilmaz gets on the end of it.
Clubs on score are definitely going about this the right way.
Jim, there's not too much subtlety or sophistication about this. It really is a question of needs must. Spot on, Peter. He's tried one! That's a half-decent try.
Yeah, he may have snatched at that a bit, even though it was quite close.
Trabzonspor are able now to make their substitution. It's been on the cards for a few moments now. João Pereira. Yilmaz gets it back. Puchka pushes it out wide. Aimed in towards the centre.
Not getting too tight, which is interesting.
Yeah.
It's probably cautionary. Don't dive in, try to pinch it or intercept so nobody can get in behind.
And it's Ayu. And Slimani!
And that would have won it.
Slimani really thought he'd scored to settle this contest, and he's struggling to believe being denied.
Chance to break. Giron goes for the cross.
Yeah, it's safe to say that they just need to manage this to secure the win now.
He's on the back foot. Forward it goes. And he's there to cut it out. And that's it. Fenerbahce out on top. Hard fought, impossible to predict. In the end, though, only the result mattered. Your final thoughts, Jim?
Fenerbahce really approached this game with clear intent, Peter, and a training ground plot